be with you. We are gathered here in this place from Colorado, this community, to worship God this holy night as we remember the commandment of our Lord. It's my privilege that we have to love one another. Perhaps it has never had more meaningless significance than it does at this time of life our country and our world. I welcome you, those of you who are streaming live and those who will watch this later tonight or tomorrow, whenever it is you choose. I welcome you with us tonight. And we seek always in our lives to worship God and to live our lives to respond to His commandment of loving God and of worship God.
Thank you.
Lord, that's where the all the Gospels. And you got to kind of realize that the Gospels, you have to realize that the disciples didn't have a clue who Jesus was. They didn't. The next thought, I think, is that they who presented out Jesus, their faith, their offering, is what it comes to. Do they believe that, Jesus is going to be a king who brought out the Romans or the Israel first? And he was serving in a distinction with two part of his covenant. One was with his wife, his blood, and all of them were authority and power and influence and wealth. And people were not just going to be a Christian and benefit from it. I think it's only at the end of his time that you can understand that this is the most important thing to do. say, well, I can't serve God. We're God. In fact, if you read the gospel, Matthew, Mark, the gospel of Jesus, pretty clearly, they were aggressively trying to not remove one another so that one of them would be greater than all the others. Because they were honored more than all the others. Thank you.
Gospel of Luke, when our risen Lord was at temple with his disciples, he took bread and arrested and broken. And the thing is that the door in their house were open, and they recognized them. They needed to recognize the Lord in the moment. And it's not viable. It's not workable. Right now, it is more visibly and invisible, not just vulnerable, but needed. The Lord is to go and our Savior invites all of those who trust Him share in the heat that He has given. So come.
The Lord is making clear that you can see the response to Him. The Lord, you lift up your heart and listen to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God, and to be the best thing in our life. Bless your heart, you know, with the God's family of the Holy Spirit. You can pour forth bread and pour out the truth in the Bible. You will receive the best of the waters to drink.
I'm going to go to the next slide.
Thank you.